sinking, isn't it?
Yeah. It's just fantastic movement over the attack line. You can see for miles if you know the right spot.
Yeah.
Or the den.
Oh. Can you hear the cups?
Sure. Just the air. Trees creaking on the wind. Not so bad.
Our little grand bed of den in the park. We had this old car seat we'd all squeeze onto.
My den was just for me.
Really?
My schoolmates, they were like, they could be in my room. Not you, but...
Thanks.
I used to call me Oxfam.
What? Why? Sorry, it's not funny.
No, it's not. Don't pour me out, don't you?
I apologise, Gavin. Go on.
Well, Dad's business had a tricky spell. We ended up alone quite a bit.
He's never mentioned that.
Yeah, we don't want to forget it. Things picked up then, so I'll walk around for him and we'll have a look back.
Right.
Say it then.
What?
Is that where I went to a big world in the Cali to prove I'd made it?
Well, you were over the speed limit.
She didn't say no, she didn't stop me. So I did take over a bit, make all the arrangements or whatever, but I thought that was what she wanted. She'd already had him dance.
I'm sorry, Gav.
There's me desperate for a wedding to be perfect, and she's just desperate to get out of it.
You don't think you'll get back together?
She was always too good for me.
Oh, you shouldn't say that.
Why not? It's true.
Maybe she wasn't right for you. That's different. I'm sure it doesn't feel like it now, but...
Plenty more fish in the sea?
Not the most tactful bloke, your dad. But seriously, there'll be someone out there who's right for you. The tricky part is finding them.
Easier said than done.
Well, I found your dad.
I know it.
You are over the speed limit.
We're sitting here in this view. I do admire what you do.
Paddling around in pools, you call it.
Truth is, you're right. It does matter.
Thanks, Gav. Right, how about I phone your dad to see if he's calmed down before we head back?
Sure, go ahead. I need you in the car.
Okay.
Hey, thanks for the coffee. And the chat. Yeah. It's out.
I'm glad. See you down there. No rush.
Yeah. Hey, love.
Dare I ask, has the red mist cleared yet?
Oh, I'm sorry, Kirsty. I feel terrible. I shouldn't have shouted at him like that. Now he's gone and disappeared.
No, he's with me. Were you saying that you needed a bit of space?
I will apologise, don't worry.
Actually, I think he might have turned a bit of a corner.
Yeah?
He seems to be thinking more clearly anyway.
After his age, you mean? That's good of you, considering how old he's been.
Well, I'm prepared to turn left in half an hour. Right, put the kettle on, because we'll be back shortly.
Kirsty.
Yeah?
I love you.
That was so good. I know. I don't think I'll do anything for you. Right, who's message me? Oh, honestly,
what?
The course I wanted to go on.
It had cancellation.
Wasn't that a good thing?
No, I wanted to go next month, but this one starts tomorrow.
Oh.
Which means a week less to work on all these arrangements.
In 100 feet, turn left.
Oh. You're going to have to have the ceremony hours, that's all there is to it.
Okay, I'm not doing anything ridiculous, and there is Chris.
You can do a reading, surely.
Oh, do we have to?
Yes.
Why are you being so awkward? I don't want Chris getting ideas again.
But about baby?
Yes, you know how desperate he is to
get next left. thick, Alice. Not everything's about you, you know.
I didn't say it was.
And I don't know why you're fighting it. You're clearly going to have kids at some point.
Yes, but some of us want to get established in a career first.
You are established.
No, I'm not.
Not by a long way.
You're overthinking it, Alice.
I had three children when I wasn't much older than you, and, well, I might as well tell you. By the end of the year, it'll be four.
Four what?
Four children. Which is a good job, because you and Debbie are hardly doing your bit to pass on the family genes.
You're knackered with trying for a baby.
You never said.
Because we're not trying, silly.
Sorry?
I'm already pregnant.
Oh, my.
Kate!
Goodness.
How far gone?
A few weeks.
Not long.
Wow, that's...
very good news.
And I'm happy to report that Jakob will be the most wonderful father.
Will he?
Yeah, well, I'll be at his flat. He has been attentive and...
You are over the steering wheel.
He's got a firm streak too, which is good, because that will complement my giving approach to parenthood.
Wait, so he's pleased about it, then?
So, what did he say?
I haven't told him yet, but don't worry about that.
Jakob's going to be delighted.
The Archness was written by Liz John, and the agricultural storyline advisor is Sarah Swickard. It was directed in our Birmingham studio by the editor Jeremy Howe. And Alice will be reeling from the gossip when we're back in Ambridge just after 7. Zoe Ball will be choosing her Desert Island Discs next.
Indignation gave me double strength, and I got loose from him by a sudden spring.
Can literary conversations from the past...
He's a much older man, he's more powerful than her.
Should light on gender relations now.
He's probably right, isn't he, when he says that nobody would believe her over him.
Will Wade presents Equal As We Are. In this series, I'll be eavesdropping on literary conversations, trying to decode the gender dynamics at play, and uncover how they continue to inform our lives today.
Equal As We Are, on BBC Radio 4, starting this Monday to Friday at 1:45.
Attempting to spot the truths amongst the lies in the unbelievable truth at midday here on Radio 4, but first it's Desert Island Discs with Lauren Laverne.
You are over the speed limit. My castaway this week is the broadcaster Zoe Ball. Throughout her 25-year career, she's grown up on air, from her exuberant early days on BBC Kids TV show Live and Kicking to a wild and wildly successful stint as the first woman to host the Radio 1 breakfast show. Her rise to fame coincided with her party years, enthusiastically chronicled by the tabloids to such an extent that the term ladette, coined in her honour, eventually made it into the OED. She's now the first woman to present the Radio 2 breakfast show, where she currently wakes up around 8 million listeners every week. These days, she's left the hangovers behind and is more likely to share garden tips with her listeners than tales of a wild night out. She says, "I've had a lot of fun over the years. Now I'm happy relaxing with a fennel tea. Just as well with a 4 a.m. alarm call." So you're all welcome to Desert Island Discs.
Thank you very much for having me, Lauren. Oh, it's funny to hear that. It's so true, though.
It is so true.
So you host the biggest breakfast show in the country. What's the secret to sounding positive and cheerful at that time of the morning, even when you're not?
I think because it's a gift of a job, Lauren. I absolutely love it. I might not love it when the alarm clock goes off and your face is full of pillow, but I've learned over the years that your feet have to go out of the bed, straight on the floor, up you jump and off you go.
Okay,
I work with such a brilliant team on the show.
You're the first woman to present the breakfast shows on Radio 1 and now on Radio 2. Are those kinds of firsts important to you?
When I started at Radio 1, I don't think I really understood how much of a moment that was. This time around with Radio 2, all eyes turned. To follow Chris Evans is one thing. To follow Chris Evans and Terry Wogan is another thing. Mm. And also there's lots of chat about you being the first girl. I hope I wasn't employed because I was in
preparation to sweat left in California.
It's a good job at this point in time, so let's give it a shot.
How has it been selecting today's tracks?
I got the vinyl out. I made a right mess.
Let's get stuck in then. Let's have our first disc. What is it and why have you chosen to?
My first tune is Barbra Streisand, Where Am I Going? It's always been Babs from the very beginning. My dad had Colour Me Barbra. I think it's a lot of show tunes on there. There's a medley. I used to do it from beginning to end, not to an audience, just to the wall or the window. And I would sing these songs that I listened to years later and think, wow, we've got quite a lot of power and meaning in this. This is something that an 8-year-old girl would not probably have understood.
In 100 feet, turn straight left.
And this one I particularly love, Where Am I Going? And What Will I Find When I Get There? You know, I love the idea.
In 500 feet, turn left.